Doctor, on my way into work this morning, I heard a story about how the city of Bangkok is closed today because of a yellow toxic pollution cloud. All the schools are closed, the government is closed. Why is that something to be concerned about?
Well, it's a global epidemic, and it really is pollution-oriented. Air quality is going down exponentially in our cities, and it affects us. It affects our physiology, and so there was 400 schools that were closed in Bangkok because of the toxicity and the environment,
wow. The
pollution. Mm-hmm. I noticed that when I was in Beijing, China, and they had me over there to do an environmental presentation on toxicity, environmental toxicity that creates disease processes. And of course, you know, I'm really fond of the research that's done by the University of Montana because they're figuring out how these particulates in the air affect the physiology in a negative way mm-hmm. to create inflammatory responses, and that cultivates the disease process. So it is a global epidemic, and it's not just in large cities. Unfortunately, even here in Michigan, you leave the office, you breathe in petrohydrocarbons from auto exhaust, mm-hmm. or not in this office, but in other offices, you might smell air fresheners mm-hmm. or new carpet or outgassing from new paint. But that's environmental toxicity. Those are air quality issues, because when you bring those chemicals, your body not only has to detoxify those chemicals to break them down into less toxic forms, but oftentimes you can have an immune response to that odor, that toxin, or that chemical in the air. And that immune reaction creates an inflammatory reaction, and inflammation is the secret silent killer. So we're exposed to these type of contaminants daily. And when the research comes out, or like on the news today, you saw that Thailand, mm-hmm. Bangkok had these high levels of contaminants in the air, so they had to shut down the schools to keep the kids from getting overexposed. Mm-hmm. So always the first thing in any issue is identify and avoid. Identify what the air condition is that's toxic and avoid it. But the second thing is you have to heal from it. You have to detoxify it. And that's why our office focuses on that. Sure, we're going to say don't smoke. Good. We identified something that caused cancer, that causes heart disease, that causes a plethora of different chronic degenerative conditions. You avoid it. But the other thing is let's say that you smoke for 10 years. Well, you avoid the smoke now because you stopped smoking, which is good. But now we have to get those pollutants out of your body. You just don't magically, okay, I stopped smoking, I don't have to worry about mm-hmm. cancer. It's not how it works. I wish it was. Those pollutants come in. Many of them do not go out. So that's where we get in there. And that's where detoxification comes into play. You hear the term, it's kind of a casual term. Mm-hmm. I need to detoxify.
Right.
And some docs say you don't need to detoxify. The reality is you have to detoxify. You don't have these mechanisms in the body were never set up and made to detoxify BPAs from plastics, mm-hmm. estrogen mimicking compounds. Phthalates, all these different chemicals in our environment, genetically speaking, our bodies were never exposed before these past mm-hmm. generations. We have no mechanisms to kick them out. So we have to detoxify. We have to use infrared saunas and special nutrients to add that extra capability to the liver, to bind in, to chelate, to start the phase 1 and phase 2 detoxification process in the body mm-hmm. to get those levels down. Because when the levels are high, you become sick. Hence, in Thailand, they're shutting down 400 schools because they don't want the kids to have that high exposure. But that doesn't mean when that exposure goes down, that when they go back out there, the exposure is gone. It's just reduced.